gentlemen, everyone here, we're going to tell you a story that's dear. Although you'll have heard this great story before, we assure you this version will not be a bore. So watch and listen to all that we do. Herein lies a message that's true. This woman is Mary. God loves her so well. He sent her a message through Gabriel.
Greetings, dear Mary. Do not be afraid. God has appointed you as his handmaid, and you will give birth to a beautiful one. His name will be Jesus, God's only son.
But how can this be? The fact is, I'm not wed. This message is making me feel full of dread.
Don't worry, dear Mary. You're safe in God's hand, and he will establish all that he's planned.
I trust in the Lord. May it be as you say.
So Gabriel left and went on his way. But Mary was supposed to be marrying Joe, and he was not happy when her this was so. Yet, he didn't wish Mary public disgrace. He felt so conflicted, just look at his face.
Joseph, there's nothing to fear. This baby of Mary's is God's only son. So marry her swiftly. It's got to be done.
When Joseph woke, he did what had been said. But he and his wife didn't share the same bed. Then came a decree from Caesar in Rome that all men must head to their ancestral home.
To Bethlehem, Mary, that's where we must go. The timing is poor and I wish it weren't so.
Don't worry, dear Joseph, all will be okay, for God will be with us each step of the way.
So Mary and Joseph set off on their trip, but they couldn't travel by railroad or ship. The journey was long and the road was quite rough, and Mary, pregnant, found the going quite tough. Eventually they got there, all tired and forlorn. And the time had arrived for the babe to be born. The innkeeper frowned, slowly shaking his head.
There's no room for you here, except for the shed.
He led them out back where the animals lay. It was quite warm and dry, and had plenty of hay. And there in the stable, mid sheep, goats, and ox, our Saviour was born, and placed in a hay box.
Nearby in some hills were some tenders of sheep, who were settling down as their flocks went to sleep.
And suddenly, boom! The sky filled with bright light and gave those poor shepherds a terrible fright.
Do not be afraid,
the Lord's angel said.
I bring you good news. Quick, get up and head to Bethlehem town, for there you will find a baby's been born who will save all mankind.
And then, suddenly, from all around came beautiful singing, a heavenly sound.
Glory to God, and to all peace on earth. Come celebrate with us our dear Saviour's birth. Glory to God, and to all peace on earth. Come celebrate with us our dear Saviour's birth.
The angels retired and the shepherds made haste.
Let's hurry to Bethlehem. There's no time to waste.
I'll take a fine sheepskin to wrap the babe in.
And I'll take this lamb to donate to his kin.
So when they arrived in the old cattle shed, they worshipped the Christ child asleep in his bed. And on their way home, they all worshipped and praised and declared the good news so that all were amazed. There came from the east, from a country afar, some wise men who journeyed, compelled by a star. They went to the new palace to find the new king. But Herod was puzzled to hear such a thing.
I've asked my advisors about your idea. They say go to Bethlehem out in Judea. And when you have found him, come back and tell me, so I may go also this wonder to see.
The star in the bright sky shone brightly ahead and led the wise men all the way to the shed.
We've come here to worship. Please take these presents.
Mine's gold.
Mine's myrrh.
And mine's frankincense.
They didn't return to King Herod that day, but warned in a dream, went home a new way.
Ladies and gentlemen, everyone here, celebrate with us and be of good cheer.
For God so abundantly loves everyone that he gave to the world the gift of his own son.
So this Christmas time, let's remember it's true. The Saviour was born for me and for you.